Block.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. There is no justification for the Intelligence and Security Committee holding secret hearings on the Security Intelligence Service Amendment Bill. The whole process around this bill has been a mockery of open government. The first bit of the process was similar to many bills. On December the 18th, a small advert was put in the newspaper public notices calling for submissions by February the 18th. But most people don't follow the public notices every day and rely on finding out from the parliamentary internet what is happening to bills and when submissions are due. However, nothing was on the parliamentary internet. Some very frustrated people phoned me and I informed them that they could make submissions by February the 18th. I presume some did, but when I asked today who had submitted, I was told by the committee, this is a secret. There is no need for this secrecy, and it departs from the normal practice of select committees, which is for the media to be notified which submissions are coming up next day so that they can plan which sessions to attend along with the general public. Of course, this time nobody other than the submitter will be allowed to attend, and even they are not allowed to know who else has submitted on the bill. If they want their submission known, the submitter has to go to the effort of promoting it to the media, as the Council of Trade Unions did today, and I will also be doing. However, as anyone who has ever attended a select committee knows, a lot of the value in submissions lies in the exchanges between the submitter and committee members, where the submitter's points are elucidated and are often taken by the committee, which is convinced to amend the bill accordingly. Asked to provide a reason why the hearings were going to be in secret, John Key said yesterday that, quote, bluntly, the reason for it is there are holes in the current legislation. Now we can have that debate in public about what those holes are, or we can take submissions from people and we can fix them, end quote. The obvious answer is why not do both? Have a public debate and have hearings which should be in public. Or is the Prime Minister advancing some strange argument that there is currently some limitation on the SIS powers that is not publicly known, and that if this became known in committee hearings, terrorists might use the knowledge of those limitations to escape detection between now and the third reading of this bill in Parliament? It all sounds weird, but this whole process of avoiding public hearings is very weird. In my opinion, the real reason is that the SIS and the Minister in charge want to avoid any serious public scrutiny of SIS activities or the laws that govern their operation or any real debate in Parliament. The Intelligence and Security Committee can get away with this because it is not a select committee of this Parliament, but a statutory committee made up of the Prime Minister, the Leader of the Opposition and their appointees. There is no evidence that the committee's scrutiny of the SIS is anything but perfunctory. Its report on last year's SIS financial review simply was that it had no matters to bring to the attention of the House. The committee, under its legislation, is quite capable of meeting in public by agreement amongst its members, as it certainly should in this case. By imposing secrecy around the hearing of submissions on the bill, the committee is reinforcing the major point in the Green Party's submission that we shouldn't be giving the SIS more powers to intrude into the private lives of citizens when it is such an unaccountable organisation in virtually every respect. This contrasts with the police, the agency responsible for detecting all kinds of crime, including politically motivated crime. We wouldn't dream of holding all the hearings on a police amendment bill in secret. This raises the question of why we need the SIS when the police are quite capable of catching terrorists, saboteurs or anyone who might be a danger to our national security. And the police are much more accountable to Parliament and the people.
Before I call the next member, could I just say to members during the general debate, to read a speech word for word is somewhat troubling. I don't want to prevent members from doing it, but this is the general debate and the contribution wasn't that technical, and a very inexperienced member like Mr. Locke, I'm sure doesn't really need to read it word for word. The Honourable, not the Honourable, Aaron Gilmore.
Not yet, Mr. Speaker.